Welcome. This video discusses handling disputes and refunds inside the Facebook local currency payment system. For a number of reasons, there will be occasional times where a user will wish to revoke a payment made in your app. As a developer, you are responsible for efficiently responding to such requests, providing a trustworthy and fair service to your customers. Facebook offers mechanisms to help you handle these requests, from being alerted as soon as one occurs, to best practices around how to process such disputes. Broadly speaking, Facebook's philosophy regarding payment disputes is that we will provide primary support for cases in which the user contends a transaction directly with their funding provider, i.e. a credit card company or PayPal. However, when a user has an in-app purchasing issue or does not receive a purchased item or currency, they should be routed directly to the developer. In the latter case, the developer is best equipped to satisfy the dispute, typically by issuing more or replacement in-app items, refunding the payment, or providing clarification on a delay to item delivery. Let's walk through a typical dispute flow to see how this works. The user can initiate a transaction dispute through Facebook.com in several ways, typically through this link on the bottom right of your Canvas game page, through user payment settings, via a receipt notification, or via a receipt email. Regardless of how the Facebook payment support flow is initiated, users are prompted to identify their issues by answering a series of multiple choice questions. Depending on the user's selections, they are directed to an appropriate contact, either Facebook or the developer. Here, the user has selected an issue best handled by the developer, which results in an additional free text input for the user to specify the reason for the dispute. After the user has initiated a dispute, a real-time update is sent to the developer. Real-time updates are fully explained in part 5 of this video series, but essentially, as a developer, you subscribe to the disputes action on the payment object, and Facebook will contact your specified server callback at the time a dispute occurs. The real-time update will contain the payment ID of the transaction. The developer can then use this payment ID to query the Graph API to retrieve additional information regarding the transaction, including the user's email address and their specified reason for initiating the dispute. It is then the developer's responsibility to use this information to communicate with the user and reach an agreed solution. After reviewing the dispute, you may choose to refund the user any amount less than or equal to the refundable underscore amount returned by the Graph API for a given payment ID. You can also issue additional refunds as long as the refundable amount remains greater than zero. Facebook does not offer the functionality to refund an amount greater than the purchase amount. In order to issue a refund, make an HTTP post call to the Graph API endpoint payment ID / refunds with an app access token and the following parameters. Currency. This is the three-letter ISO code of the currency in which the refund amount is specified. This must be the same as the currency in which the original purchase was denominated. Amount. This is the amount to refund. Reason. This is the reason for the refund being issued. This will be communicated to the user. The response from Facebook will be true on success or an error code otherwise. The payment object is then updated with its actions field including details of the refund. For complete details on how the payment object is changed after a refund is issued, please refer to the Payment Graph API reference doc at developers.facebook.com/docs/reference/api/payment. In the previous example, the developer has been primarily responsible for handling a user dispute. There are, however, circumstances in which Facebook will assume the primary point of contact for the user. There are two broad definitions in which this is likely to occur. A non-fraud dispute. This is a user request for a monetary refund related to a mistaken purchase or misuse of a financial instrument by a family or friend. For these types of dispute, Facebook reviews a user's refund request on a case-by-case basis. Typically, these requests are as a result of user confusion, where the purchase was made accidentally due to a misunderstanding of the purchase flow. Our qualitative investigation examines factors including previous orders, spending frequency, and account level details. Facebook will refund the charges only if the user's reason for the dispute is deemed appropriate to receive a full reversal. Facebook monitors refund rates to protect against users who might attempt to defraud developers or Facebook by abusing the dispute resolution process. A malicious fraud dispute. This is an unauthorized purchase associated with a stolen financial instrument or a compromised account. In these cases, Facebook will typically seek to fully refund a user as quickly as possible. Doing so prevents the user having to resort to a chargeback and builds trust with honest users who may fall victim to fraud. If Facebook determines that this dispute is valid and that the user should be refunded, we will recover the cost of such a provision from the developer. Facebook does this by deducting the refunded amount from the next payout made to the developer at the end of the payout cycle. We will only do this for transactions disputed within 90 days of the original transaction date. As with disputes, you will be notified via a real-time update when Facebook refunds an order. Also, as before, additional information will be added to the Graph API return data for the payment. Rather than an additional disputes array, there will be a refund field added to the actions array, signifying the payment has been refunded. A chargeback occurs when a user of your app contacts their payment provider directly, i.e. their credit card company or PayPal, to dispute a transaction. A chargeback can happen for a variety of reasons, including unauthorized use of a financial instrument, double billing, or non-receipt of a virtual good. If the payment provider issues a refund, Facebook will recover the cost of the chargeback from the developer. Again, Facebook does this by deducting the charged back amount from the next payout made to the developer at the end of the payout cycle. Facebook will only do this if the chargeback occurs within 90 days of the original transaction. Beyond 90 days, Facebook will be responsible for the cost of the chargeback, apart from in some very infrequent edge cases. These are detailed in the documentation listed here. Incurring chargebacks and refunds is a normal part of operating any online business. Handling disputed transactions in an accurate, fair, and timely manner is a responsibility of the developer as part of providing good customer service and maintaining user trust. If there is a reason for concern, please reach out to Facebook via our help center at facebook.com/help, and we will work with you to investigate your individual app or use case. For more information about disputes, refunds, chargebacks, or fraud, please see the URL listed here. Thanks.